I missed the whole thing. I was talking. I was talking thinking that I have been recording and I wasn't recording. So here I am again from the beginning. So I wasted my effort. Okay, but in the background you can hear it's for Israel. Israel is dead. That's what I had said. Israel is dead. Israel is dead. Not the country, not yet, but Israel, my uncle. So finally, my uncle Israel is dead. Okay. And we don't know yet when he's going to be laid to rest at the or, you know, what do you call it? Tendelo la funeraria. I don't know when the wake is going to be yet. Yeah, the wake. Okay, but maybe today, maybe tonight he'll be put out. I don't know how to say this in English. Lo van a atender en la funeraria. They're going to attend him. They're going to string him like a cloth line. Tender en la funeraria. He's going to be late at the for viewing. He's going to be put up for viewing at the funeral house. Maybe tonight or maybe tomorrow. I don't know yet. We don't know yet. We haven't heard the final arrangements yet. But that's Olga Tañón singing in the background. This all makes sense now because of things that I have said in the past. And here what's going on RT. Okay. That's what's going on in RT on West Coast. Let me see what's the plan. And we're talking about different things. So we're talking about Israel sending somebody to the talks in about the peace treaty, guaranteeing the security of Israel for like the next 7 years, I believe, in fulfillment of Bible prophecy. Okay? And I don't know what this is. What's the plan now? What is that about? I don't know. Something. And then on the under that, it says Russia's like grow and breakthrough deal reached in Geneva over Iran nuclear program. And plan B, heavy American women might need to find a plan C. No level effectiveness, if not effective, 176 pounds, loss of effectiveness, 165. They're talking about people like Fat Amy in pitch play, perfect pitch. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, hello, Rebel Wilson and the people of the movie, wonderful movie, Perfect Pitch. Okay. And here is the sign of the other channel is the sign of the apocalypse. Okay, but right now they got an advertisement from Kay and you know, two young people that are getting married apparently. Okay, but yeah, I'm watching Seven Signs of the Apocalypse. This is from 2009, and it says the seven signs prophecy predicting Armageddon appears on a Greek island in 100 AD and keeps a powerful hold on the imagination 2 millennia later. So this is the apocalypse of John the Divine that I have talked about before many times. I even made a couple of songs, MacArthur Park, etc., that I have associated with it. So you know this, Lucas, this will look crazy, but I have to repeat it for many people that maybe they hear this video the first time. Okay, so this is back to me now. It's recording. It's 3 minutes. I lost the first recording. I thought that I don't know what happened. I thought the recording was on, and I realized that no, I missed the whole thing. So everything I had said, I lost it. But I had originally I had posted this song because the name is Olga Tañón. My father, my uncle Israel is dead, and he was married to Olga. Yeah, like Olga Kurilenko in your movie November Man. So he finally succumbed to a little tumor, apparently, that I did not know about. And my sister was telling me yesterday, for the first time I hear that he had a tumor. And I mentioned this thing about my other uncle, Antonio, who had his nickname was El Tumorcito de Leonila. He was Leonila's little tumor because people could not believe that my grandmother was pregnant again. She was too old to be pregnant again, so people could not believe and accept that she was pregnant again, so they took to calling the pregnancy a little tumor, El Tumorcito Leonida. So he, when he was born, he was nicknamed Leonila's little tumor. El tumorcito de Leonila, people just couldn't tell. The nickname actually stuck. People knew him as el tumorcito de Leonila. Believe it or not. Well, his name was Antonio. He's the only one that stayed in Cuba because, among other things, he was of military age. So he would not have been allowed to leave Cuba. And that's my cousin in Havana that is an oncologist. So this all relates. My cousin is an oncologist. His daughter, who was born in the accident, Milagros, and she's an oncologist. She was born in the accident. They were going to Havana with Nona, about to have give birth when they were involved in the accident, him driving the taxi. So they named her Milagros for Miracles because she was born in the taxi after the accident. They couldn't get to Havana. She was Nona gave birth to her right in the cab. Okay, so that's why she was named Milagro. I've talked to her, I've talked to you about this before or written about it, because she's an oncologist now. She's actually involved in cancer research. Ironically or coincidentally or divine providence, she's actually involved in cancer research, and you can look her up. There's papers on the internet, journals, scientific nerd, with her name associated with other cancer researchers. So this is Olga Tañón, and I had associated this song with Samuel Coach because that's how the whole thing started with Mico. If I get into the whole thing, it's going to be a very long tape. So I cannot repeat everything, but that's the crumb trail, as I call it, that led finally to you, Lucas, because Mico led me to Samuel Coach, and Samuel Coach led me to you. And in the movie Monte Carlo, you mentioned that you were paralyzed for 1 year. Well, Samuel Coach was involved in the accident that we all know about now. Justin Bieber was supposed to appear that night, so this is all related. And Cameron Diaz also, among other people in the audience that were in there that was supposed to show appear that night in the show, very popular show in Germany called Wetten Bass. Wetten, is that what it's called? It means you want to bet. What do you want to bet? And Samuel Coach tried to jump over the cars, and that's when he fell. He had the accident, and then he became paralyzed. So this is how one thing led to another, and eventually led to you. And I have posted. I bit my inside. Oh, shit. That's how I had associated this song even before I met you, Lucas. Even before I became aware of you last year in the movie Monte Carlo, I had associated this song with Samuel Coach because he fell unconscious. So there's a part of this song that says that it's a little bit facetious, really, on my part, poking a little bit of fun at poor Samuel Coach, who is now tragically paralyzed for life. But he fell unconscious. So there's a song, there's a part of the song here. I had also associated another song about him because of the supposedly the coming of our second son coming. I've talked about this before, so if I talk about everything, it's going to be a very long take. And then the song, you don't get to hear the song and me singing the song at the end. It gets truncated. You don't get to hear. So let me sing the song because it's already 8 minutes. So let me sing this song. So it's for Israel. For Israel, my uncle, who is now dead. He died yesterday morning, the 25th of November, 2013. He was 85 years old. So let me sing this song before I go on and on and on and talk about all this, and then you don't get to hear anything. You don't get to hear me singing the song, which is the important thing, right? It's a beautiful song from Olga Tañón, from the composer and also singer himself, Marco Antonio Solis. Beautiful songs, beautiful singer, Olga Tañón, beautiful voice. He and Marco Antonio Solis, talented singer and composer, and been around for a long time. Desde hoy me he prohibido a mis ojos el mirarte de nuevo a la cara. Soy you, Lucas. Tienes algo que acaba conmigo, que a mi mente de mi alma separa. So my uncle Israel, who's dead, tengo que renunciar a quererte antes que ya no tenga remedio. Si mi vi la dejara tu suerte, mi camino será un cementerio. Y basta ya de tu inconsciencia, de esta forma tan absurda. Eso es unconscious, inconsciousness. De ver a diario cómo echas a la basura. But the meaning is a little different, man. Somebody who's not mi corazón, lo que te doy. Con tanta fe de ver en ti felicidad. I'm giving it a Spanish accent. Me llevaré la dignidad. Estás en tu cuerpo. Haré de todo mi interior nuevo sendero. Y lloraré hasta lograr. Ya, día, ya no te pueda recordar. And I mean, I'm recording here. I'm recording for you here, Lucas. My letter mate. And then they're reading there, la tristeza es como una esponja que absorbe el agua de la vida hasta hacerla morir. Lilith. It says underneath, Lilith. If you watch this, it says Lilith. Okay? Lilith was Israel. He said, y hasta que... Basta ya de tu inconsciencia, de esta forma tan absurda. De ver a diario como echas a la basura mi corazón, lo que te doy. Con tanta fe de ver en ti felicidad, me llevaré la dignidad de no caer más en tu cuerpo. Haré de todo mi interior nuevo sendero. Y lloraré hasta lograr que algún día ya no te pueda recordar. And I'm recording for you, Lucas. I'm recording this song for you and the world, man. And my uncle Israel, who's dead at 85 years old. Israel, his first name was actually Nemesio. But a llorarte hasta lograr que algún día ya no te pueda recordar. And the song says, no me quiere, no me quiere, me quiere, no me quiere, lo suponía. There's a bunch of plus signs and some skull. Some, there's a bunch of skulls on one side. So you're gonna see this when I put it, post it. Muchos ven lo que pareces, pocos sienten lo que eres. Okay, so, and it's Lilith. Lilith in the his first name was actually Nemesio, but in Cuba it was very, very customary for somebody to be given the first name and then everybody called them by the second name. So that was the case with my uncle Israel. His first name was actually Nemesio, which has to do with Nemesis. And the other thing that I posted for Nibiru, the coming of the second son. So which is something that I had associated with also Samuel Coach. Because, you know, the two sons come together only once every 3,600 years. They come close enough that they unleash a bunch of cataclysms on Earth. Every time this happens, if this is all true. So I had associated the song with this, the coming of the two sons, being Samuel Coach being a very bright sun, like sunshine, because his Sandra Miko's mother used to call Miko sunshine. Yeah, this has to do with Christian Grey too, because Charles Unan used to be in Queer as Folk, and the American version with the guy who plays sunshine. Yeah. Okay, so I've said enough. If I say too many things, they will get truncated, and I'm trying to pull all these things together to make sense. You will have to read all this. So remember Vega. Vega is 25 light years from Earth, but 800,000 years to travel there. So it doesn't look like we're going to make it this time. The signs of the apocalypse are upon us. A 7-year treaty now being signed. And this is in fulfillment of Bible prophecy. And other prophecies throughout the world that don't even have to deal with directly with the Bible. many prophecies now fulfilling the same thing that everybody's talking about. And after that, the 7 years of World War III probably is what's going to culminate in everything coming to an end. But maybe there's something else here, because people have talked about maybe an earthquake. That there will be a giant earthquake, gigantic earthquake, that's going to rip apart the whole Middle Eastern part of the world. Some people say that this is going to open a waterways from the Mediterranean going out to sea, the other end, the other side. So that's really beyond what anybody can do, any man can do. Wars could be prevented even, but not a gigantic earthquake. That is beyond the capacity of men to stop. So maybe that's all part of the divine intervention that Jesus knew about, because he saw, like I like to say, he saw the movie. He came to Earth and spliced himself into our movie, present day, 2,000 years ago in Palestine. He spliced himself into our movie. And that's why he came to warn us about all these things that are going to happen in 2,000 years, which is actually now happening. So that was why he said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. That was the beginning of the age of Pisces that followed the age of Taurus of Egypt. And now, 2,000 years later, is the end of the age of Pisces. Some people think that we're already in the age of Aquarius, or at least we are at the cusp. We're going from, if we're not already in the age of Aquarius, we're in the cusp going from Pisces to Aquarius, which is in fulfillment of saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. So this is what Jesus saw. This is what he tried to warn us about 2,000 years ago. And now it's all coming true, apparently. So that's why I'm doing this song. So it's from my Uncle Israel, who is now dead. I don't know when the funeral is going to be. But like I said, Lucas, if you're in the Miami area and you wish to go, and you go on now, I got this recording so that they know if you want to come. Just show up there if you want to go, man. You representing my dad. You're my dad. So you go there and you say, I am Luke Bracy Vega Bell. Just tell him that. I am here representing Omar's father, Vega. Yeah. That's all you need to say. Just tell him, I am Luke Bracy Vega Bell. Okay? You go and represent my dad. Yeah. Okay, bye. Today is Tuesday 26th of November 2013. And it's 4:40 p.m. It's 16:40 hours, or 16:40 hours. Okay, so let me cut it short here, because if I don't do this, it gets cut out at the end for some reason. Even though I'm allowed to record over 15 minutes, and you have seen some of my tapes are 15 minutes, something happens when I try to make the recording too long. It gets compressed. And then the audio track doesn't match the video track, and then they cut out the end sometimes even. Sometimes it plays to the end, sometimes it doesn't play to the end. So if you are hearing this, it is now 17 minutes. I keep biting my inside. I get nervous. My teeth are all over the place. So it's 18 minutes and 8 seconds and counting. Okay, so remember Vega. And Father Vega and my Uncle Israel, for Israel. Okay, my Uncle Israel. So, see you later, Lucas. Thank you very much, man, if you're in the area. Yeah, maybe they'll put him out tonight. Tonight or tomorrow night, okay? And if you go, you're going to get to meet Lilith, probably. Lilith will be there. And my cousin, my Uncle Nemesio, actually his first name is Israel, but now they took to calling him Nemesio. They didn't want people to call him Israel. He's been Israel to me all my life. Now they wanted me to call him Nemesio, like they all do, because his son is now the new Israel. His son is the new Israel. And he's the one married to Lilith. Okay? So, or was married to Lilith. Okay? So, to the next 13,000 years, look. New heaven, new earth, and a new man. Lucas Homo Lucens, and the Lady Eveth, like not Eva, not Lilith, but Lady Eveth, combination of both of them, okay? 19 minutes and 22 seconds and counting. Bye-bye. Thank you.